In just a moment, the leading presidential candidate for the Republicans, Donald J. Trump, will be with us for the full hour. By the way, unlike fake news, CNN, it's not my job to sit here and debate the candidate. We're going to ask him about the issues of the day that actually matter to the people that came out here tonight in the rain and thunder and lightning, the voters, and they will also have their questions as well. Nothing is off the table.
Yeah, but isn't it?
Follow-up questions appear to be off the table. Fact checks definitely off the table. The table is pretty much cleared so that Donald Trump can just lay on it and just gyrate in conspiracy theories and lies and misinformation without being obstructed in any way. I get that Sean Hannity is going to make a statement like that because he wants to like lord it over, like see, like look, CNN was so mean to him, but I'm not gonna be. But it's also like, you thought I was a journalist. What the hell's wrong with you? I'm just going to let him loose, buddy. Brett, what do you think?
Well, it's just like he proved that he is going to lay down and let Trump do whatever he wants. When he used Trump-ish the language in his setup to how the night's going to go. Fake news CNN. Mm-hmm. Like, we know what is happening. We've seen the previous interviews you've done with the guy when it's just one-on-one and your job is to challenge him on things when that is a journalist interviewing a president, if you go with what he'd have you believe about him. And he's laid over and just laid down and let Trump walk all over him. And that's absolutely what's going to happen tonight. But that's just my conjecture, John. I think you've done the research to discover whether that actually took place. And I'm sure you've got plenty of videos for us.
Exactly. Well, I can say that we're going to have a little bit of Hannity receiving some pushback despite he's already announcing, I am going to be puddin' soft. And like, he's also signaling to them, if I ever raise anything that seems critical, it's probably setting up a strong man so that Donald Trump can knock it down. But even so, that audience has been trained to be so sensitive and so like ready to sniff out disloyalty, because all of them, their entire stock and trade is identifying people who are disloyal to Trump. And so you're raising them to do that. So he's going to be struck down by it a little bit. But I do like him admitting before a live studio audience that he's not a journalist. He has no aspirations to be. That said, why don't we jump into one of the first questions that actually has to do with the classified documents, the big revelation from earlier this week.
News broke yesterday that there might be a tape recording that, quote, where you acknowledge that you understood that these were classified documents. First of all, do you know who this call may be with? Do you know anything about it?
No, I don't know anything about it. All I know is this. Everything I did was right. We have the Presidential Records Act, which I abided by 100%. Biden has 1,850 boxes with a lot of classified stuff that he's not supposed to have. In his case, I have the right to declassify as president. He's got 1,850 boxes that he doesn't want anyone to see. He had 7 or 8 boxes in Chinatown. In Washington, D.C., where nobody even speaks English in Chinatown. Chinatown is very, it's in favor of China. And he has boxes in Chinatown. They took those boxes and they sent them to Boston to his lawyer, so his lawyer could look through them and probably do things that you're not supposed to do.
Dear God, it's time for Grandpa to go to bed. The Chinatown thing? What in the hell did he get off on that, that nobody speaks? They like China. I'll say that. Jesus.
That's like saying little Havana loves Castro. Are you speaking a lot of Mandarin in Chinatown?
No.
Like, a lot of people are here because they didn't like China.
Yeah, it's super weird. But anyway, I guess that's a distraction, I suppose. So Biden has documents which he's not supposed to have, even though he's present. So theoretically, he can telepathically declassify them. I guess it doesn't work for him. I guess the power went away. The magic was gone after Trump left office. That defense right there was utterly pathetic. It was barely a defense. He didn't say that conversation didn't take place. He certainly didn't respond to the content of it. If it did take place, all he said was, I'll say this, everything I did was good.
Literally.
And the crowd began to cheer. Everything I've ever done is good. That's your defense? What if Hunter said that? Would you buy that as a defense? So anyway, and by the way, there's plenty of room for follow-up questions, Brett, but we know we're not going to get them because Hannity already announced that he's not a journalist and he's not there to provide any pushback.
Right, and it's like, I'm just going to set you up to do whatever you want. and then say that you've answered the question when the question wasn't a real question you would give in an interview. And Hannity's completely wrong to say that it's not his job to debate the candidate. It's his job to challenge the candidate, to be the voice that moderates the discussion. So keeping it on track, making sure to get clarification where clarification necessary. I think if the tables were turned and Fox had, say, Bernie Sanders on, which they've had in the past in town hall settings, and those moderators, they gave up later because they realized Bernie was winning, but they tried to hold Bernie to task. Same with even Pete Buttigieg. They have these, they don't have a consistent standard for how they treat candidates that's agnostic of their party. It's absolutely based on partisanship. And we always already knew that.
Yeah, 100%.
By the way, at the end, the projection of he had the boxes, and so he probably did what people do. Like, we already, like, Hannity didn't even mention that there were all those revelations about it wasn't Taco Pina. It was the other Trump lawyer who's like, he went in and was asking about searching other places, and the aides were like trying to direct him away from searching certain places. And then they cleared out the documents the day before the DOJ got there. Like, these are really great areas to ask follow-up questions about, but we're not going to get those because Sean Hannity doesn't want to get booed.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.